The last few days, I've been playing Hexcodle, a variation of Wordle. You're shown a hexadecimal color and given 5 guesses to identify its value. After each guess, you're told if each digit is too low or too high. So what's a good strategy for this game? It turns out there is a strategy that guarantees we can always guess the correct color in 5 guesses or less, even if we can't see the color. Let's talk quickly about hexadecimal colors and then discover this optimal strategy. Hexadecimal, also known as base 16, is a base for writing numbers that's built on the number 16 instead of the value 10 that we typically use. In hexadecimal, the numbers 0 through 9 are written as usual, but when we get to 10, this is now a single-digit number that we write as A. And then 11 is B, 12 is C, 13 is D, 14 is E, and 15 is F. Once we get to 16, we now wrap around and have a 2-digit number that we write as 1, 0. The 1 is in the 16's place, and the 0 is in the 1's place. So this number is 1 times 16 plus 0 times 1, which is 16. Then the numbers continue by increasing the 1's digit and so on. The largest 2-digit hexadecimal number is FF, which is 15 times 16 plus 15 times 1, what we normally call 255. And the smallest 2-digit hexadecimal number is 00, which is 0. One common way to represent colors digitally is with web colors, which are used on the internet and in many other applications. Each color is represented as an amount of red, green, and blue, which we often abbreviate as RGB. Each of the red, green, and blue components has 256 possible values, ranging in hexadecimal from 00 to FF. We place the value of each component next to each other to get the hex representation of a web color. For example, pure black is written as 000000, since there is 0 red, green, and blue. White is written as 6 Fs, because we want the maximum amount of red, green, and blue. Pure red is FF0000, with the maximum amount of red and 0 green and blue. There are a total of 256 cubed colors we can represent this way, about 16.7 million. In Hexcodle, we're asked to guess one of these 16.7 million colors in just 5 guesses. Even with the hints, this might seem like a difficult task. There are way more possible colors than words when we play Wordle. But it turns out, since the game tells us if each of the digits is too high or too low after each guess, there is actually a strategy to guarantee that we can guess the correct color in at most 5 guesses. The strategy doesn't even require us to look at the starting color, so we don't need any experience in identifying web colors. So how does this strategy work? We'll need to take full advantage of the hints, whether each digit in our guess was too high or too low. We'll need to deal with a 6-digit hex code, but for now, let's just focus on the first digit. Once we know how to guarantee our guess for this digit, we can apply the same strategy to all other digits at the same time. If our starting guess is 0, there are 2 possible outcomes. There is a chance that we did guess correctly, otherwise our guess is too low. So this guess isn't utilizing the hint at all, since all we're going to know at the end of our guess is whether our guess of 0 was correct or not. There will still be 15 possibilities remaining for this digit. If instead our first guess was 1, then there are 3 possible outcomes. We might have guessed correctly, or we might have guessed a value too high, in which case we'll know the true value is 0. But the most likely situation is that our guess was too low, and in this case there are still 14 possibilities for this digit. To fully utilize the hints, we should instead guess a value somewhere in the middle. Since there are 16 possibilities, a guess of 7 or 8 would be in the middle. We could build our strategy with either one, so let's just pick 7. If our guess is too high, then we'll know the true value is somewhere between 0 and 6, which is only 7 possibilities. And if our guess is too low, we'll know the true value is between 8 and F, which is only 8 possibilities. By making just one guess, we've reduced the possibilities for this digit from 16 to at most 8. This is a type of divide and conquer strategy known as a binary search. We guess the value closest to the middle, and our feedback will tell us if the value is in the lower half or the upper half. So our first guess is 7. Let's say that that guess is too low. The true value is between 8 and F. Now we guess the value halfway between 8 and F. There are an even number of options, so we could choose either B or C. So say we pick B. If our guess is too high, then we'll know that the true value is either 8, 9, or A. And if our guess is too low, then we'll know that the true value is C, D, E, or F. There are at most 4 possibilities remaining after 2 guesses. For the third guess, we again pick a value halfway through the remaining possibilities. At the end of this guess, there are at most 2 remaining possibilities, and we still have 2 more guesses. So we can just guess each of the remaining 2 until we have the correct answer. And at most 5 guesses, we have guessed the first digit. We can apply that exact same strategy to each of the other 5 digits simultaneously so that we'll have all 6 digits correctly guessed and at most 5 total guesses, guaranteeing us to win the game. Binary search is a powerful tool since it runs in logarithmic time. For example, if each digit had 1,000 possibilities instead of 16, we would still be able to solve the puzzle in at most 11 guesses. If each digit had 1,000,000 possibilities, we would only need 21 guesses to solve it. Admittedly, when I play Hexcodle, I make my first guess based on the color, since I think it's fun to try to guess the values rather than always guessing 7s and 8s. But after I realize that initial guess is way off, the binary search will help me to win. Please consider liking and subscribing to support the channel. Thanks so much for watching till the end, and I'll see you next time.